call 209 here, and I'm going to explain a situation that I came across of on New Year's. Usually on New Year's, everybody goes out, they shoot their firearms. Hopefully you're shooting them in the ground or shooting them in, you know, a berm or something. Because don't shoot it up in the air, because what goes up must come down. For those people that just don't know that. So don't shoot your firearms in the air, because, you know, that's bad. So I went outside on New Year's, and I shot on the side here into the berm on the side of the house. Unfortunately, I only got off 2 rounds. And by the time I cleared up the malfunction, this is how long it took. New Year's was about 10 minutes young. So I hung it up after that. So I've taken apart my Glock 43, because this is what this is, a Glock 43. I traded my Glock 19 for this gun because I have a CZP-10C, and why do I need a Glock 19? I don't have a 43, and it's a little bit easier to carry this gun in the summertime. But I digress. So what I experienced on New Year's, it's a malfunction I've never come across with, and I've had tons of guns and I've had tons of malfunctions back in the yesteryears, and if you go along the channel you can see a lot of malfunctions that I've had with guns. It just comes with the territory. I always tell new shooters, people that are middle of the road in their infancy of owning firearms, to shoot their firearms, to shoot the ammunition they carry in firearms. For self-defense, I carry either critical duty, critical defense, or some kind of other type of hollow point, whether it be some Winchester defense stuff or whatever I can come across. Now, we all know about the ammo crunch. It's pretty hard to find stuff. And when you do find, especially hollow points, you're paying, I've only seen them to about $30. I did come lucky at a different location. We're at the old Rule King, and I found some hollow points for $16.99 a box, which isn't bad. But again, we've seen a lot of this foreign kind of ammunition and these new ammo companies spring up and just start throwing ammo on the shelf. What I like to tell these people that are in their infancy or new gun owners is to run your gun. Run your gun, run the ammunition that you're gonna have with it. If you're going to have to pay a little bit more, I always run a box of whatever carry ammo I have through my gun, a box. Some people will be like, oh man, that's expensive. It's expensive, but my life is more expensive, so I want to make sure my gun works. So at that point, I was running these rounds. These are critical, I believe they're critical duties. These are the Hornady brand with the little, if I can get it to focus there, with the little red tip in there. Now, I've had problems with this ammunition feeding into a firearm before. I want to say it was my Bursa BP9CC. I think it was that gun. It didn't quite like these guns. It would run it, but I would come across a malfunction once in a while. I had... when ammo was cheap, and I could find these for like, you know, I think it was like $11.99, $12.99 a box. I shot 3 boxes of these through that gun to make sure, this is back in the day now, when we didn't have all these problems that we have, that we have in 2021. But, I had a couple of problems with that gun, and I switched it out some Winchester defensive rounds. And the Winchester defensive rounds work better in that gun than the Hornady, I think it was Critical Duty or something like that. It was the one with, it's either the Critical Duty or the Critical Defense, but it worked better in that gun, so that's what I run out of that gun. So when new shooters and people talk to me at the gun counter or just in general, I tell them, make sure you run your defensive ammo. Make sure it feeds through there properly. You're not going to have any hang-ups or anything. So when I went out there on New Year's and I shot 2 rounds, I shot it out of this magazine, the Precious magazine. And I've had a couple of hiccups with this kind of magazine. It is a Glock mag, as you can see there. It is a Glock mag. But I always tell new shooters again, or people in their infancy of owning firearms, when you start sticking the Tacti-Tards cool stuff on there and the thingamabobs and the thingamabitches, You gotta make sure these things work. Now, the only kind of problem I've really experienced off this magazine is the slide not locking back. That's not a done deal for me. You know, it's not critical in that kind of aspect. But this malfunction is, I took this gun apart to show you. So your barrel is here. I shot two rounds and the slide locked back. And I wondered why the slide locked back. And I looked at the slide and it wasn't locked back because, you know, the round didn't feed or anything like my SD9VE did. It was because the next round it tried to feed was jammed up underneath the feed ramp here and stuck like that. So this got caught up into the slide and everything, and it jammed it up, and it caught the lip of the case, caught right here on the back side of the slide. I've never experienced that in my life. You know, I've had guns, you know, not feed rounds and stuff, but I've never had a round nosedive that bad to the point where it gets stuck underneath the feed ramp and kind of flips up. And as it flipped up, you know, I looked down the slide and I'm like, oh, that's not good. So I tried to eject the magazine, tap, rack, and bang, as they say, and the magazine would not come out. You know, after I tap, rack, and bang, it would not, I couldn't free up the slide. It pretty much locked the slide where the slide couldn't reciprocate. So I had to basically take the gun like this and yank the magazine out. And then as I did that, the magazine came out and two extra rounds kind of plopped out of there. So the round underneath the one that was stuck was already getting forced from the magazine. It was a ball of mess. How that happened, I don't know. But again, I've had a couple of problems with the way the bullet is shaped on the Hornady one because it's really pointed. So sometimes that can cause malfunctions in guns if they don't like that. Here's another example. As you can see here, this bullet is a little bit wider than the critical duty or the critical defense, whichever one that is. And I've never had a problem on these, and I think these are Winchester defense rounds, and I've never had a problem out of those. This is only the second time I've kind of encountered this, but yet I've shot this gun before with this kind of ammunition in there and never really had a problem. Unless it's the magazine, the base plate that is causing the malfunctions or the slide to not lock back. I don't know. I can take off this base plate because I have like 8 magazines for my 43. And I can change this base plate out, put this on here and try and use a different magazine. Maybe this one, maybe it's wearing out. Maybe the spring in there is wearing out. I don't know. But I've never encountered something like that before where the tip of the round was caught up under there like this. And then everything else was kind of popping out of the magazine and it got stuck into the slide like that. Again, if I was defending myself, you know what I'm saying? God forbid, if I was defending myself, I'd be out of the fight real quick. To a certain extent. I don't know about you, as my heat kicks on. I don't know about you, but with me, I carry two guns. I've always carried two guns for this purpose. You know, I'll either carry, you know, a pocket gun and, you know, one on my hip, or I'll carry a gun in my car just for this kind of problems that you may, you know, come across in your time of conceal and carry. I always carry two guns. When I go on a road trip, I carry three guns. You know, I carry a rifle and I carry two extra handguns. That's just the way I am. Call me crazy, but I'd rather have it and not need it than to need it and not have it, as the saying goes. So always look into that for the new people, even people that are really experienced in firearms. Don't come complacent to thinking, you know, this gun has never really had a malfunction and it's going to be great. Because you never know what the gun's gonna do. So it's always good to go out there, shoot it, shoot the rounds that you're gonna put in there. Again, I've never really encountered this kind of problem with the Hornady critical duty or critical defense. I've never had this kind of problem, and this gets me thinking now. Was it the little rubber tip that became the problem, or is it just a fluke of occurrence? You could have those. I've had a gun. I think it was my PT-709 with stovepipe a lot. And then I kind of tweaked that gun and tweaked the magazine. And I never had another issue with it. You know, maybe it's something like that. But I don't really take the time to sit there and gunsmith on guns. I'm not really a huge gunsmither. You know, I like my guns to come out of the box and work well and make sure I maintain them for the future. So I'm not a huge gunsmith person. But I've had a couple of guns that I've kind of tweaked over the years. My CZP-10C, I got a trigger put in that one. And just like night sights and things like that, I've installed on firearms. So I'm not a huge gunsmithing person. But this one, this is something I've never encountered. It was weird. It was very, alarming, to say the least. And again, I brought the gun in after I cleared that malfunction and cycled the rounds through the firearm, pulling the action back. And it seemed to work. But again, you know, I'm not shooting it and it's not giving me the violent reaction of recoil. So I'm not sure, but I'm kind of thinking maybe it's the base plate. Again, I've had like Pro Mags and stuff just not work. And I've had other base plates that I've installed that have kind of hiccuped the gun. And then I've taken those base plates off, put the originals on, and never really had a problem after that. So I'm always telling people to be curious of what you put on your guns, to make sure they work, to constantly run your gun to make sure these doodads and these thingamabitches and these thingamabobs that you're throwing on your gun don't cause issues further down the road. So we'll have to see. I'll load some of these other rounds up, and I'll see if I can recreate that malfunction or see if we get another malfunction. Now I have changed from this magazine just to a regular Glock mag with the pinky extension on there, and changed them out to some Winchester defensive ammo, because it seems to work with all my other guns. Again, I've had a couple of problems with the Hornady brand out of a gun here or there. Maybe it's just the way the bullet is shaped, with it being so narrow at the end. I don't know, but this is the first time I've ever encountered that with any gun on New Year's. So I just wanted to bring that to your attention, to you guys that are, you know, in your infancy, or you're in the middle of the road of your journey, and even some people that are well-established gun owners. Run your guns. Run the ammo in there. I know ammo is expensive right now, but I think my life is worth it to spend a couple of extra dollars and run a box or two of the carry ammunition that I'm going to use to make sure my gun works. So that's the little story I have for New Year's. I usually record those little New Year's pops on the camera, but in my set of the mind frame, I'm more focused on figuring out what the issue is with the gun, how could I fix it, than sticking a camera, everywhere. I mean, I think that's a lot of the problems with the population nowadays. They always have to put stuff on film. But if you go on my channel, you can see a lot of other guns that didn't quite work. So I wanted to share that with you. Always remind you to carry your firearms. I know it, again, ammo's expensive, but I feel my life is priceless. I like to thank my old and my new subscribers and just the people that zip through. I greatly appreciate it. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe. To everybody, including me on YouTube, to help push the algorithms so these things can get brought up in the feed. And let's create a discussion down below in the comment section. Like always, guys, we'll catch you on the next one.